was that?
Jesus.
That was creepy.
I'm hearing somebody right now.
I don't like it in here. We just discovered something that we should.
I'm shaking right now. What's that?
There's something walking.
Right there.
Let's get your asses down here.
Holy crap. We're coming. Katrina!
At the heart of downtown Buffalo stands the Statler City Hotel, a once vibrant luxury destination that was the talk of the town in the roaring 20s. But behind the 18-story brick exterior, the hollow halls that once held some of the 20th century's most storied figures are filled only with the ghosts of the hotel's sordid past. Built by Ellsworth Statler in 1923, Statler City was the crown jewel of his hotel empire. Jazz legends such as Dizzy Gillespie, Bessie Smith, and Coleman Hawkins played packed rooms in the basement nightclub. U.S. Presidents John F. Kennedy and Franklin Delano Roosevelt both took closed-door meetings in the hotel. Even notorious mobster Al Capone was a frequent guest, enjoying the hotel's view of Canada while overseeing his underground bootlegging routes. After decades of bankruptcies forced the former Grand Dame of Buffalo into a ghastly state of disrepair, the current owner purchased the property at auction in 2011 and refurbished the two lower floors as an event space. But while the living may again tread under the chandeliers of Statler City in moments of celebration, the dead have never left. Wedding guests were shocked when a black figure appeared in photographs lurking behind the bride and groom. Contractors fled from apparitions roaming the upper floors. Local paranormal investigators recorded disembodied voices calling out for help and were petrified when unseen hands hurled stones at them. Now, Nick and Katrina will spend 72 hours in the largest location they have ever investigated. Using cutting-edge audio and visual technology, they will document the hauntings and try to bring to light what dark guests never checked out of the Statler City Hotel.
Oh, wow.
This is awesome.
I get to live here for 3 days. It definitely feels like I'm checking into a luxurious hotel instead of a terribly haunted location, but it looks can be deceiving. So something's telling me not to get too used to the posh lobby.
You can almost feel what it was like back then when this was in operation.
Oh yeah, you can hear the music, the people talking, and Connor?
Hi.
Hey, Katrina.
Connor works for the owner of the Statler City Hotel and is planning renovations for the building. He has reached out to us after recent reports and experiences of aggressive paranormal activity.
This was the Grand Dame of Buffalo back in 1923 when it first opened.
So this is like the place to be if you came to Buffalo.
Absolutely. This was the place to be for a banquet. This is the place to be, you know, seen, dressed up, and you wanted to come and dance. Go to the rendezvous downstairs, and that's where it was swinging.
Al Capone, did he stay here?
Al Capone stayed here. Some of Buffalo's famous mobsters back in the day have stayed here and drank here. And I'm glad you guys are here because, you know, we're looking for some answers. One of the places I want to show you is the terrace room because we have a famous picture sent in by a guest. It seems to be an apparition. It was just bizarre.
Oh, cool. All right.
Yeah, let's go check it out.
Cool. Well, the terrace room used to be the supper room for the whole hotel. So this is where people would come and eat breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And the craftsmanship is like nothing seen today.
Can you walk us over to where this apparition? Because this is the picture that actually intrigued me the most.
The figure was just right here. And you could see the people in the tables. You could see their faces very clearly in the picture. This figure, you can't. It's just a dark mess.
Before we leave here, was there anything else that has happened in here that you've heard of?
I was in here one day, and I heard footsteps going up towards the stairs here.
How many experiences would you say that you can't explain?
I've had probably at least 10 paranormal experiences. And I've been touched, I've been spoke to, had doors closed right in front of me. It's probably one of the creepiest. This is the Georgian Ballroom. A lot of psychic mediums come in here, and they're always drawn towards this fireplace. There's the energy of a whole mobster. There's a deal gone wrong, and he's still here, but his body was taken away. The activity here is pretty intense. We have intelligent responses.
Really?
Yes.
Feels like it.
Are there any other locations that we should focus on?
Yes, absolutely. This is the soon-to-be-renovated floors of the Statler.
History-wise, what is special about the 8th floor?
March 17th, 1947, a young lady at 22 and jumped out of the 8th floor.
Oh.
She left a suicide note saying she was lonesome and sad.
So that's at 22?
Yes. Mary Jean Carlo.
Mary Jean. Even though the 8th floor doesn't look how it looked during Mary Jean's days, it doesn't mean that she's not there. One of the working theories in our field is that when people renovate buildings, you're essentially raising the energy in the room, so things are getting stirred up and becoming active. All right, Connor, well, thank you so much. This was
thank you.
Amazing.
Thank you for coming. I appreciate it, and we're very excited to see what you find out.
Okay,
great. Connor, we'll see
we'll
you in a
couple
days.
We'll let you know in a couple of days.
Good luck.
All right, thanks.
Well, I think we have a long investigation ahead.
Very long day. Very long couple of days. Hello, hello.
Hey, guys.
We meet Dan Kleas in the lobby. Dan has investigated Statler City dozens of times. He called us here to see if we can follow up on the ominous presence that spooked his team and give Connor some answers as to who or what is haunting the hotel. First, Dan takes us to the rendezvous room, the nightclub where his team collected unexplainable audio evidence during their investigation.
This is like everything I've ever seen out of a movie during that time.
Yeah, totally. Yeah. So some of the voices that come through are pretty clear down here, huh?
Yeah, this is one, this is an EVP.
Are you stuck here?
Did you hear that?
Yes.
I am stuck. Is that what it says? I am stuck.
Let's play it again.
Are you stuck here?
Wow.
I am stuck.
It's a clear whisper. It makes me wonder what happened to him.
Yeah, these aren't answers that we haven't gotten yet, so that's what we're hoping that you guys can get these answers.
And you would tell me on the phone, there's another area where you've had a lot of stuff happen?
Yeah, it's actually a Turkish bath. It was originally to the 1920s, and there's a lot of things that have happened to us down there.
Okay.
Let's head over there.
Let's go.
So now this is going into the basement.
Yes.
It's a different feeling down here, huh, Dan?
Oh my gosh, yeah, you just really just start to feel it when you get down here.
This is amazing.
One of my teammates went into the pool and actually had a rock thrown at him multiple times.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, geez. That's exactly what it sounded like.
Wow.
He was down here by himself with one camera,
really?
And that happened to him. And I just remember that bellowing screech that he made.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he was scared.
Did you hear that?
I did.
I heard a little pebble.
Oh.
Right there.
Whatever.
There was a little pebble. You heard it dropping, right?
Yeah.
Right here. Is there someone back here? Can you throw a rock so we can see how strong you are? All right, so later on, we'll come back down here. We'll investigate this whole area. We can try to determine what this malicious spirit wants, but we have a long journey ahead of us.
Yeah, we do.
We'll call you soon?
Yeah.
Thanks, awesome.
Dan. All right, guys. Good luck tonight.
Thanks, Dan.
All right, buddy.
After hearing about Dan's experiences, we begin our first night investigation in the Turkish bath.
Hello? It's pitch black down here. Hello?
Let's try the geoport.
Yeah.
So this is modulating EMF, vibrational waves, and also radio frequencies, plus electricity, giving us clearer voices than we've ever heard before. Can you hear me? Can you come to my voice and use this device to try to talk to us?
You going in? Hey, Nick. I'm going to stay out here like Dan's investigators, see if we can recreate what happened.
Okay. Is there someone still down here? It doesn't like people swimming in this pool or entering this part of the building. Are you here with us right now? Can you speak to us?
Whoa, what was that?
Whoa.
Oops. enter? Is it okay if I come over this way?
I don't understand how you can pick these.
No way! What the f was that?
I don't understand how you can pick these up.
Whoa! What the f is that?
Jesus.
Where did that even come from? Be careful. This is all construction.
That was so loud.
Do you see that big metal drum over there?
This
thing almost sounded like somebody took a metal drum and slammed it. I'm shaking right now. Holy.
It went boom.
Let me just see.
That was startled the crap out of me, man.
Would it be that?
What was that?
That was Kat.
Drum. This. Is that it? Yeah.
Pretty much, man. It was like loud.
That's what it sounded like.
I'm going back in the pool. That's where it was happening.
Right. I'm gonna stand where I was standing.
Can you do that again? Can you lift that up and throw it?
Up here. It's upstairs. That's above us. Nick, what the f- is going on? Somebody's moving around up there. That's where they captured that picture, the wedding that Connor was telling us about with the torso and the head. That's the room. So it's like these. I wonder if they're connected somehow.
This is insane. Let's head up to the ballroom. Is there someone in here?
It's kind of creepy in here.
It's very creepy. There's so much energy about this place. It's almost maintaining that. The parties.
Yeah. Party's still going.
The party is still going.
Hello?
Nothing looks out of place.
Actually, I want to see something. Right?
Yeah, that's what it sounded like.
We heard things happening in that room when we were downstairs, but when we went upstairs, everything looked to be in place, and it was very quiet. We didn't have any responses. We didn't get a strong sense of anything. So I'm wondering if maybe the terrace room is more residual, and the pool room is an intelligent spirit. All right, so the Georgian ballroom, one of the only rooms that has everything original. I'll say this, though, just standing here, putting my hand on the fireplace, like my heart is racing.
Honestly, what do you think about sleeping here tonight? Because I have to go down and face that Turkish bath.
I'll sleep here. I could sleep like right here.
Okay.
Maybe if it's ever here, we'll come through.
It's scary down here. It's a different feeling. All right, I'm gonna set the 360 camera up. So dusty down here. What'd you say? I'm hearing somebody right now, and on my 360 camera, you can see it here. I'm rolling on my 360 camera, and I can see everything in the entire room. There's something down here with me. Just heard moaning. Day two is here. Day two is here. Are you going to investigate for a bit?
One's empty and
Chandeliers. Woo-hoo! Good morning, everybody.
Yeah. I'm obviously a morning person.
Amazing look in the morning.
This is like an old meat locker.
Oh, yeah, that's right. This totally smells like death, doesn't it? I can't stand it. How long is this?
What?
I need to get out of this room. It just smells so bad. Yeah, it just smells. Yeah, no, I'm fine. I just can't stand that smell. It's gross.
Do you want to go get Rob?
Yeah,
you
should be back by now. I'm gonna get ready. Wash my face.
Get ready. Wash your face.
Put myself together. Right. And then we'll get Rob and start the day.
Cool. Whenever you have a beautiful hotel like this, there's always ways to hide secrets. There's really not a lot of information that we've dug up through our research, but there is one death, Mary.
Back in the 90s, the construction workers would see a woman walk up here, and it would happen around the end of the workday, so around the time it is now. And also people...
Is there someone here with us? Is that you, Mary? Are you trying to let us know that you're okay? Do you need help? Symbolizing an end, as well as a beginning,
signifying renewal. That's Whoa. Right here. And Almighty God. It's right here. Can you knock again? If you need us to help you, can you give us two knocks? If you want us to leave, can you give us three knocks? If you want us to leave, can you give us three knocks?
That was three clear knocks.
I said three to leave.
That was knock, knock, knock.
We're going to use the Spiritus app through Wellen's video ghost box. This is ITC, instrumental transcommunication. Through this and the app, they can actually communicate and manipulate so we can see a visual. That's right
on
the window.
Right.
That's literally right on the window. Be careful.
I will. Could that be it? Okay, so that is sucking in and out.
Is there a hole behind there?
Hear that? But I don't know if that's all the noises we were hearing, because
I swear it was right on
stuff
the,
up there.
I swear it was right on the window.
I heard something right on the window too, but some of the noises might have been that. So I would say maybe 3/4 of the knockings we were hearing are explainable, but there were other knockings that weren't coming from below the window or at the window area that were really coming from above. And right now I don't have an explanation for those.
Can you please walk in front of me so I can see you?
Mary? Mary Jean?
Yes.
We keep hearing knocks on the ninth floor. Is that you?
What?
Girl. Did
girl.
You hear that in the back?
Yeah.
Girl. Who's the girl? There is a noise over here, Nick.
Over there?
Yeah. I can't pinpoint where it was, but somewhere in this direction. Mary?
Annie. Oh, it goes Mary.
Mary?
No more knocks. Isn't that crazy? There's no knocks. There's no thumps, knocks. There's no noises.
I think we need to go to rendezvous, because whatever is down there, according to Dan, according to Connor, it's a very talkative spirit, and we might be able to get some answers from that room.
Can we get this party started? Let me know on the thermal camera if you see any cold or heat signatures.
Mm-hmm.
We're actually trying to see if there's any indications of energy formations. And we're going to use the Portal app. and we're going to run that through the Wonder Box. This is a new device that we've been getting really good audible sound coming through.
So basically, anytime we hear a clear word in English or maybe even another language, it means that this thing is working and something's manipulating that gibberish to communicate with us.
Exactly. I'm going to start this now.
What's that?
There's something walking. That was a loud sound. It came from over here.
For lack of better words, it just feels very crowded in here. Do you know what I mean? Like, I feel like I'm walking through waves of people.
Really?
Yeah.
This should be a good place for one of us to sleep. I just get that feeling like when you're by yourself, something might happen.
It might. Let's set up a camera in the terrace room and let's go to the pool.
Okay. The terrace room is big, so we're gonna use the 360 camera right now. So we'll be able to move the camera around left, right, above, below, and we'll be able to see everywhere. That's all set. All right, let's go downstairs. Okay. Ready?
I'm gonna mess with some of these placements. Because if there is a spirit up here trying to make everything nice and pretty or, you know, pack everything away, then maybe it'll get pissed off that these things are out of place. Are you making fun of me?
Very cool.
Aww.
Oh, I messed up the mess up.
Okay, I'm shutting this off for a second.
We're confined to the biggest location we've ever investigated. It's 950,000 square feet, and this is absolutely amazing.
Look how awesome these fish are.
Nick, get back here.
You okay? Katrina! You okay? Katrina!
I'm rolling right now. Holy f***.
What?
That was effing crazy. Rob, you heard that.
I heard that. That was like a muffled moan.
A muffled? It was like,
That's what I heard when I was sleeping downstairs last night.
You heard that?
Yes.
But That was right here.
Dude, that gave me goosebumps because I actually heard that downstairs.
Nick, do you think what you heard came from here, from this room?
No, it was in the pool room. I just heard moaning.
I am freaking out right now. That was so stupidly loud. My mic would have picked it up.
It wasn't recording to anything. If you cut your camera.
Yeah, I cut my camera, damn it.
You know what? And let's recognize that it was literally
seconds after I cut my camera. That was crazy. It sounded like somebody was trapped. It's pretty dusty, huh?
Yeah.
I can't believe you slept down here last night.
Neither can I, dude. This is like inches of dust and dirt.
I don't like it in here.
We're back. All right, let's get to it. It's so quiet.
Yeah, just water dripping over there.
Last night, we were down here for all of, was it 15 minutes? Before that drum banged and we heard that metal sound and the chairs dragging across the floor. I'm gonna step out. I wanna see what happens with you just in it. Okay, I'm out of the pool. It's a totally different feel down here tonight.
We go back upstairs to the terrace room to review the footage on the 360-degree camera to see if it captured anything while we were in the Turkish bath.
My mind is doing gymnastics. I'm looking around at this room trying to figure out if there's any natural explanation for that. I don't know if I've ever heard a DVP like that without having the live EVP equipment set up or...
Meaning like not having to play it back to hear it?
Well, no. So a DVP stands for direct voice phenomena, and it's when you hear it with your own ears. You don't need a recorder to play it back for you. That was so loud and so clear. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Does anything look out of place?
I don't know. I have to look through the whole entire room, so I'm gonna have to scan through this to make sure I'm not missing anything. I think morning's gonna be here really quick.
Yeah.
What do you think about going back down to that nightclub and sleeping down there?
I think I need to sleep here.
Oh, you want to sleep in here?
I heard somebody. I want to know what that was.
All right. So let's regroup in the morning. Rob, yeah. When you get back, we can go over all the footage.
Let's get going.
Last night from when we had the 360 camera in here. So I'm really curious to see if he got anything. He's been at it all morning. Hey, anything?
Yes.
Really?
You have to see this.
What did
it's
you find?
Absolutely amazing.
Please, don't
watch this.
Okay, you're gonna look right here.
Get the f- out. Please, don't
watch this. Isn't that crazy?
Get the f- out. Are you kidding me?
Yeah, look, I get goosebumps watching it.
Can I just point out that you guys made fun of me for moving chairs around? Like I was a lunatic?
No, it was.
Wouldn't you know it, we have a chair that moves on camera, and it is awesome because it doesn't just move, it like moves and then adjusts itself. So it's not just one movement, it's three. And that's amazing because that confirms what we were experiencing in the pool room on our first night when we were hearing all those chairs move. And we walked upstairs and nothing was out of place. Something is happening in the terrace room. At some point tonight, we need to separate with one of us downstairs, one of us up here.
All the lights just went off, as you just said that. Did you see that? That camera's filming, right?
What'd you get?
All those lights on the wall. You see all the lights?
Yeah.
They were all lit up. They just went off.
There's one of us up here.
Let's grab our Wonder Box to try to make contact with whatever turned that lights off, whatever was moving this chair, whatever else is going on here. I want to try to get to the bottom of this. What? I said dis.
Are you down in the pool right now? Is it two separate people? One in the pool, one up here?
No.
No?
No.
Some of the activity seems sporadic. Some of it seems disjointed from each other, where I'm not really sure if we're dealing with one really active spirit. I think we might be dealing with a couple. So I'm really hoping for night three that we figure out who this is, or at least what their story is.
We're getting closer and closer with whatever is here. We're gonna start off by using the Wonder Box. We've had great luck so far. Are you still here with us?
Did you used to work here?
He goes, that's not it.
That's not it. Okay, did you used to come here? Were you a guest?
That's two different voices.
Were you a guest?
Who are you talking about? Are you talking about something that happened here? Were you hurt? Beat up? Killed?
It's like a really intense pain. On the side of my head.
You okay?
Yeah, it's weird. I haven't had this the entire time we've been here, so I don't think it's me. Did you hurt your head? Did you get a head injury? What is that?
Did something happen down below in the pool? Did something happen down below in the pool?
Why do we keep getting activity up here? Are they connected?
Where do you want us to go right now?
Go out the back door?
What back door? There is no back door in this room.
If you can do me a favor, grab one of these cameras. Can you go to the pool area? Walking me when you're down there. Tell me if anything happens in the pool area when you're by yourself.
Okay, yeah, we can try it.
Cool. Here's your walkie.
Check.
Cool.
All right. You guys.
Check.
Cool. Have fun.
Yeah. Careful.
I really don't want to do this.
Be really careful wherever you're walking down.
I know. I don't want to do this. It's so dangerous down there.
I know.
All I'm saying is 20 minutes.
Hey, Nick, do you copy?
Yeah, I do. Yep.
Okay, I'm in the pool room. Okay. So I am back in the pool. I hear a Nick. Nick, just an FYI, every time I come into the pool and ask questions, like, my legs are freezing. This is weird. It sounds like really light shuffling or footsteps. You coming from over there?
What's the matter? Right there.
That's us.
Guys, get your asses down here right now. Something crazy is going on.
We're on our way. You okay?
Guys, you're looking at us, dude.
That's us.
Guys, get your asses down here right now. Something crazy is going on.
We're coming, we're coming.
I heard you. But I don't know where you are.
Katrina, you're okay?
Yeah, come down here though.
I can't see. Hold on. What's the matter? Are you okay?
I was in the pool. I couldn't see like 2 feet in front of me and heard, I don't even know if it was rumbling or banging, and it was over there.
Let's go check it out.
Yeah. You know, I just had a thought. Look how many metal drums there are in this area alone. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I wonder if it's been trying to lead us to this area the whole time.
Oh my God, I just saw something.
What?
Do you remember Dan played that EVP?
That and he said, I'm stuck.
I'm stuck.
Do you think it's like a person stuck in something?
It could be unstuck, the
like
barrel.
Literally unstuck.
Yes.
You
know what's strange? Is Dan and Connor both talked about the mob. And this could be the malicious spirit that is throwing rocks, scratching people, trying to get some sort of attention. Maybe he was hurt really bad.
Yeah.
Or it's his spirit trying to say, I was murdered. There's 3 spots here that we've had stuff happen. The club. The party, the pool. This is getting crazy.
Where do you want us to go right now?
Go out the back door?
What back door? There is no back door in this room.
We have to go to the club. Can we go to the club?
Yeah. Were you a guest?
I just thought of something. Holy
what do you mean? What?
The f***ing joke, man. The back door makes perfect sense. Let's just speculate here for a second. From the terrace room, they're having a party. All the guys get together. They came down to this area. Something went bad in the conversation here. Someone gets hit on the head.
It's like a really intense pain. In the side of my head.
So maybe they killed the guy. Remember what Dan told us? Where was he getting his voices? I'm stuck.
I'm here. I'm stuck.
Why would you be stuck in here? What's behind this wall? Look at this.
Oh, this is the back door.
Where's the most quiet place you go to hurt somebody? I'm guessing.
Is this one?
Isn't that what's crazy? The whole time. This is the one spot we haven't investigated.
Yeah.
Maybe he was brought into this area right here, and he was beat up in this room, killed, put in a barrel, dumped in the river off the property. Let's try making contact and see if this is the place they took his last breath. Did you die down here?
Yeah.
Did you die down here?
Did somebody hire someone else to hurt you? Who hurt you? What's their name?
That just said it was that boss.
Wait, nobody was moving just now?
I heard this.
Something Johnson?
What?
I heard two names. That's just not crazy. I heard and Johnson.
That was a family here.
What?
It was. That was a family here. That was a big one. That was a New York family.
Did it just say the boss's name?
That's crazy.
You know, originally I thought that we were dealing with two different things. One upstairs in the ballroom, one downstairs in the pool room. But maybe they are the same thing. Maybe they're different things, but they have the same story. Maybe the same things happened to them. And that's why they're still here.
Can we get out of this room?
I just don't feel right in there.
Can we get out?
Next step out, seriously.
Yeah, let's go.
I can't breathe, honestly.
There's something very active haunting this hotel. And I'm positive that they have multiple spirits here. But I have to wonder after our investigation with all the evidence we had. Are you making fun of me?
All right, cool. Oh, I messed up the mess up.
Yeah, I'm shutting this off for a second.
We're confined to the biggest location we've ever investigated. It's 950,000 square feet, and this is absolutely amazing.
Look how awesome these fish are.
Nick! Get back here!
You okay? Katrina! You okay? Katrina!
I'm rolling right now. Holy
what?
That was effing crazy, Rob. You heard that.
I heard that. That was like a muffled moan.
A muffled? It was like,
That's what I heard when I was sleeping downstairs last night.
You heard that?
Yes.
But that was right here.
Dude, that gave me goosebumps because I actually heard that downstairs.
Nick, do you think what you heard came from here, from this room?
No, it was in the pool room.
Okay, if you're looking at us, dude.
That's us.
Guys, get your asses down here right now. Something crazy is going on.
Well, no way. You okay? That's us.
Guys, get your asses down here right now. Something crazy is going on.
We're coming.
I heard you. But I don't know where you are.
Katrina, you're okay?
Yeah, come down here, though.
I can't see. Hold on. What's the matter? Okay. Are you okay?
I was in the pool. I couldn't see like 2 feet in front of me and heard. So it's like these, I wonder if they're connected somehow.
This is insane. Let's head up to the ballroom. Is there someone in here?
It's kind of creepy in here.
It's very creepy. There's so much energy about this place. It's almost maintaining that. The parties.
Yeah, party's still going.
The party is still going.
Hello?
Nothing looks out of place.
Actually, I want to see something. Right?
Yeah, that's what it sounded like.
We heard things happening in that room when we were downstairs, but when we went upstairs, everything looked.
There's something down here with me. I just heard moaning.
Day two is here. Day two is here. Are you going to rescue for a bit?
When it's empty and...
Chandeliers. Woo-hoo!
It's so quiet.
Hey, just water dripping over there.
Last night, we were down here for all of, was it 15 minutes? Before that drum banged and we heard that metal sound and the chairs dragging across the floor. I'm gonna step out. I wanna see what happens with you just in it. Okay, I'm out of the pool. Totally different feel down here tonight.
We go back upstairs to the terrace room to review the footage on the 360-degree camera to see if it captured anything while we were in the Turkish bath.
My mind is doing gymnastics. I'm looking around at this room trying to figure out if there's any natural explanation for that. I don't know if I've ever... So this is like the place to be if you came to Buffalo?
Absolutely. This was the place to be for a banquet. This is the place to be, you know, seen, dressed up, and you wanted to come and dance. Go to the rendezvous room downstairs, and that's where it was swinging.
Al Capone, did he stay here?
Al Capone stayed here. Some of Buffalo's famous mobsters back in the day have stayed here and drank here. And I'm glad you guys are here because, you know, we're looking for some answers. One of the places I want to show you is the terrace room because we have a famous picture sent in by a guest. And it seems to be an apparition. It was just bizarre.
Oh, cool. All right.
Yeah, let's go check it out.
Cool. Well, the terrace room used to be the supper room for the whole hotel. So this is where people would come and eat breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And the craftsmanship is like nothing seen today.
Can you walk us over to where this apparition? Because this is the picture that actually intrigued me the most.
The figure was just right here. And you could see the people in the tables. You could see their faces very clearly in the picture. This figure you can't. It's just a dark mass.
Before we leave here, was there anything else that has happened in here that you've heard of?
I was in here one day and I heard...
I don't know if I've ever heard a EVP like that without having the live EVP equipment set up or...
Meaning like not having to play it back to hear it?
Well, no. So a DVP stands for direct voice phenomena, and it's when you hear it with your own ears. You don't need a recorder to play it back for you. That was so loud and so clear. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Anything look out of place?
I don't know. I have to look through the whole entire room, so I'm gonna have to scan through this to make sure I'm not missing anything. I think morning's gonna be here really quick.
Yeah.
What do you think about going back down to that nightclub and sleeping down there?
I think I need to sleep here.
Oh, you wanna sleep in here?
I heard somebody. I wanna know what that was.
All right. So let's regroup in the morning. Rob, when you get back, we can go over all the footage. Let's get going.
According to Connor, it's a very talkative spirit, and we might be able to get some answers from that room.
Can we get this party started? Let me know on the thermal camera if you see any cold or heat signatures. Mm-hmm. We're actually trying to see if there's any indications of energy formations. And we're going to use the Portal app. And we're gonna run that through the Wonder Box. This is a new device that we've been getting really good audible sound coming through.
So basically, anytime we hear a clear word in English or maybe even another language, it means that this thing is working and something's manipulating that gibberish to communicate with us.
Exactly. I'm gonna start this now.
What's that?
Yes, ma'am.
There's something walking. That was a loud sound. It came from over here. All right, I'm gonna set the 360 camera up. It's so dusty down here.
What'd you say?
I'm hearing somebody right now. And on my 360 camera, you can see it here. I'm rolling on my 360 camera, and I can see everything in the entire room.
You heard it dropping, right?
Yeah.
Right here. Is there someone back here? Can you throw a rock so we can see how strong you are?
All right, so later on, we'll come back down here. We'll investigate this whole area. We can try to determine what this malicious spirit wants, but we have a long journey ahead of us.
Yeah, we do.
We'll call you soon?
Yeah.
Thanks, awesome.
Dan. All right, guys. Good luck.
Thanks, Dan.
All right, buddy.
After hearing about Dan's experiences, we begin our first night investigation in the Turkish bath.
Hello? It's pitch black down here. Hello?
Absolutely. This is the soon-to-be-renovated floors of the Statler.
History-wise, what is special about the 8th floor?
March 17th. 1947, a young lady at 22 and jumped out of the 8th floor.
Oh.
She left a suicide note saying she was lonesome and sad.
So it's at 22?
Yes. Mary Jean Carlo.
Mary Jean. Even though the 8th floor doesn't look how it looked during Mary Jean's days, it doesn't mean that she's not there. One of the working theories in our field is that when people renovate buildings, you're essentially raising the energy in the room, so things are getting stirred up and becoming active. All right, Connor, well, thank you so much. This was amazing.
Thank you. Thanks for coming. I appreciate it, and we're very excited to see what you find out.
Okay,
all right,
great.
Connor, we'll see you
we'll
in a couple
days. We'll let you know
days.
In a couple of days.
Yeah. Good luck.
All right, thanks.
Well, I think we have a long investigation.
Very
ahead of
long
us.
Day. Very long couple days. Hello, hello.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Dan. We meet Dan Clayus in the lobby. Dan has investigated Statler City dozens of times. He called us here to see if we can follow up on the ominous presence that spooked his team and give Connor some answers as to who or what is haunting the hotel. First, Dan takes us to the rendezvous room, the nightclub where his team collected unexplainable audio evidence during their investigation.
This is like everything I've ever seen out of a movie during that time.
Yeah, totally. Yeah. So some of the voices that come through are pretty clear down here, huh?
Yeah, this is one, this is an EVP.
Are you stuck here?
Did you hear that?
Yes.
I am stuck. Is that what it says? I am stuck.
Yeah, let's play it again.
Are you stuck here?
Wow.
I am stuck.
It's a clear whisper. It makes me wonder what happened to him.
Yeah, these aren't answers that we haven't gotten yet, so that's what we're hoping that you guys can get these answers.
And you would tell me on the phone, there's another area where you've had a lot of stuff happen?
Yeah, it's actually a Turkish bath. It was originally to the 1920s, and there's a lot of things that have happened to us down there.
Okay.
Let's head over there.
Let's go.
So now this is going into the basement.
Yes.
It's a different feeling down here, huh, Dan?
Oh, my gosh, yeah. You just really just start to feel it when you get down here.
This is amazing.
One of my teammates went into the pool and actually had a rock thrown at him multiple times.
Really?
Yeah. Jeez. That's exactly what it sounded like.
Wow.
He was down here by himself with one camera,
really?
And that happened to him. And I just remember that bellowing screech that he made.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he was scared.
Did you hear that?
I did.
I heard a little pebble.
Oh.
Right there.
Whatever.
There was a little pebble. You heard it dropping, right?
Yeah.
Right here. Is there someone back here? Can you throw a rock so we can see how strong you are?
All right, so later on, we'll come back down here. We'll investigate this whole area. We can try to determine what this malicious spirit wants, but we have a long journey ahead of us.
Yeah, we do.
We'll call you soon?
Yeah.
Thanks, awesome.
All right, guys. Good luck.
Thanks, Dan.
Bye, right, buddy.
After hearing about Dan's experiences, we begin our first night investigation in the Turkish bath.
Hello? It's pitch black down here. Hello?
Let's try the geoport.
Yeah.
So this is modulating EMF, vibrational waves, and also radio frequencies, plus electricity, giving us clearer voices than we've ever heard before. Can you hear me? Can you come to my voice and use this device to try to talk to us?
You going in? Hey, Nick. I'm going to stay out here like Dan's investigators. See if we can recreate what happened.
Okay. Is there someone still down here that doesn't like people swimming in this pool? Or entering this part of the building? Are you here with us right now? Can you speak to us?
What was that?
Whoa.
Enter? Is it okay if I come over this way?
I don't understand how you can pick these.
No way! What the f was that?
I don't understand how you can pick these.
No way! What the f was that?
Jesus.
Where did that even come from? This is all construction.
That was so loud.
Do you see that big metal drum over there?
This
thing almost sounded like somebody took a metal drum and slammed it. I'm shaking right now. Holy.
It went boom.
Let me just see.
That was startled the crap out of me, man.
Would it be that?
What was that?
That was Kat.
Drum. This. Is that it?
Pretty much, man. It was loud.
That's what it sounded like.
I'm going back in the pool. That's where it was happening.
Right. I'm gonna stand where I was standing.
Can you do that again? Can you lift that up and throw it?
Up here. It's upstairs. That's above us. Nick, what the f*** is going on? Somebody's moving around up there. That's where they captured that picture, the wedding that Connor was telling us about with the torso and the head. That's the room. So it's like these, I wonder if they're connected somehow.
This is insane. Let's head up to the ballroom. Is there someone in here?
It's kind of creepy in here.
It's very creepy. There's so much energy about this place. It's almost maintaining that. The parties.
Yeah, party's still going.
The party is still going.
Hello?
Nothing looks out of place.
Actually, I want to see something. Right?
Yeah, that's what it sounded like.
We heard things happening in that room when we were downstairs, but when we went upstairs, everything looked to be in place, and it was very quiet. We didn't have any responses. We didn't get a strong sense of anything. So I'm wondering if maybe the terrace room is more residual, and the pool room is an intelligent spirit. All right, so the Georgian ballroom, one of the only rooms that has everything original. I'll say this, though, just standing here, putting my hand on the fireplace, it's like my heart is racing.
Honestly, what do you think about sleeping here tonight? Because I have to go down and face that Turkish bath.
I'll sleep here. I could sleep, like, right here.
Okay.
Maybe what's ever here will come through.
scary down here. It's a different feeling. All right, I'm gonna set the 360 camera up. It's so dusty down here. What'd you say?
I am hearing somebody right now. And on my 360 camera, you can see it here. I'm rolling on my 360 camera, and I can see everything in the entire room.
Just heard moaning. Day two is here. Day two is here. Are you going to rescue for a bit?
One's empty and...
Chandeliers. Woo-hoo! Good morning, everybody.
Yeah. I'm obviously a morning person.
Amazing look in the morning.
This is like an old meat locker.
Oh, yeah, that's right. This totally smells like death, doesn't it? I can't stand it for long.
What?
I need to get out of this room. It just smells so bad.
Yeah,
it just smells. Yeah, no, I'm fine. I just can't stand that smell. It's gross.